Hello guys, alaikum, my name is Muhammad Ali and today we are gonna be covering do while loops and do until loops. So let's get started. Okay, welcome guys. In this tutorial I told you that we're gonna be learning about do loops. So what is a do loop? Do loop is basically a loop which keeps on running until the condition is false. Okay, which that would be keeps on running until the condition is false. So let us look at the do loop. We have this do loop. The basic loop would be do and loop. That is the basic structure of it. Okay, similar to like for x equals 1 to 10. And then next x. Okay, everything has end. Similarly, if has and if. Okay, similar to these guys, the do loop has do and end would be loop. Makes sense. Okay, the first thing we are going to be learning about is do while, as you've seen in the title. So do while x is less than 10. Okay, until x is less than 10, keep on running. When it x is 10, terminate the program. Okay, where name x as integer, where x equals 1. Okay, we need to initialize this, and this is our counter. Okay, well, if you don't have a counter, it's gonna just keep on running infinitely. So you need a counter. We're gonna say do while x is less than 10. Okay, that is understandable. Okay, if x is less than 10, what to do? I want you to do is basically what we did in the previous tutorial. Okay. Okay, you need to put this counter in here. If you don't, that would be every time it will be increased by 1. So first time the x will be 1, the second time x will be 2, the third time x will be 3, and so on. So we're gonna try and run this. We're gonna say 1, okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now x would be 10. Yeah, x is 10. When I come in here, it's gonna say, yeah bro, x is 10, you can't go on because 10 is not less than 10. That's false. So it's going to say answer. That's all. Okay. Well, you can actually put this condition in here. That is not an error. Okay. So let's see how it works. We're going to say go. It works great. It's the same. It's not a problem. Well, that's incorrect. Let's see how. If I say x is less than 1, okay, that would be 0, but now x is 1, so x 1 is less, not less than 1, so the program should be terminated, right? But if I try this, it's gonna say x is 1, okay, it's gonna come and do the program once, and see now the x is 2, it's gonna say 2 is less than 1. So what we learn from this is it's gonna at least run one time whether the condition is true or false. Okay, whether the condition is true or false, it's gonna run at least once. Okay, so if you want something like to run at least once, if whether the condition is true or false, this is how you do it. I prefer it here, so I'm gonna put it here. Okay guys, see you in the next part. Okay, welcome again. So now we have a simple do loop. Okay, we're gonna be doing do until. What is do until? Do until is the loop which keeps on running until the condition is true. Okay, by the way, I accidentally wrote then when I was telling you about do while, so I think that was problem. I was like, what the hell I did? What the hell did I do? Okay, whatever. So we're gonna be learning about do loop. That's all. Do until loop. So what is do until? Do until is something which keeps on running until the condition is true. Okay, so let's see, we're going to say do until x is greater than 10. So when and if x becomes greater than 10, stop. Okay, let's see, we're going to say like cells x ratio 1 dot value equals x, where x equals x plus 1. Okay, we're going to run this, we're going to say f8. Okay, it's not 10, it is not 10 because greater than 10, because 10 is not greater than itself. 1 is not greater than 1, 1 is equal to 1. So it's going to again run, it's going to say 10. Okay, now it's going to say sorry, you can't proceed. Okay, so you're going to just go and get out of here. Okay, until can be in here. Okay, you can put until in here. Okay, until, let's see how it works. It works great, there is no difference. Let's see, no difference. But similarly, it's going to work at least once. If x is greater than 1, no, if x is greater than 0, even if x is greater than 0, we're going to run this. Let me come in here and just clear this. We're going to say if x is 0, it's going to come in here. If we're going to say x is 1, it's going to come in here and put the value of 1 in here. And then I'm going to say, okay, it's going to say x is now 2. 2 is greater than 0, it's true, then it's going to terminate the program. Well, that's, I think, is the dangerous way to work with this. Okay, guys, see you in the next part. Okay, guys, so we have some integers in here. That would be 1 to 10. We have our basic do loop in here. So let's see how to terminate this. We're going to say do until x is greater than 10. Okay, I'm going to say if cells x ratio 1 dot value equals 7, then terminate the program. That would be exit do. It's going to just exit the do. Let's see how it works. And then I'm going to say message box to tell me what is x at the end. Okay, we're gonna say just go through. It's gonna say x is 1. Okay, then x is 2. X is 3, 4, 5. Let's see, it's 5. Now it's 6. Now it's 7. It's gonna go in here. Check, it's 7. It's gonna say that it would be equal to 7. It's gonna then exit the do. It's gonna just come back and show me that the end of the value which I have gone through is 7. Okay, I think that's all. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching. If you have any question regarding this tutorial or other tutorial, make sure to put it in the comment box below. Okay, and make sure to like, subscribe, and comment. And please make sure to share it with your friends. Okay, thank you, and bye bye.